Here at Brenner Children's Hospital, we probably treat 2 to 3 patients per month for Kawasaki disease, so it is more common than people think. And the signs and symptoms to look for have been carefully outlined by the American Heart Association, and it is fever for at least 5 days. And then there are 5 other criteria we look at, and that is the whites of the eyes become bloodshot, the lips become dry and cracked and red, there may be lymph nodes in the front of the neck that become swollen, the hands and feet can become swollen, and the palms and soles can become red. And then the last one is rash. And we look for 4 of those other 5 criteria: changes in the eyes, mouth, the neck, the hands and feet, and the rash, along with the fever for at least 5 days, to say this may well be Kawasaki disease. There are some patients who don't have that, which is called complete Kawasaki disease. There are some patients who don't have all those criteria, don't have 4 of the 5, and we call those atypical or incomplete Kawasaki disease. And it's important that those patients be diagnosed as well, because incomplete Kawasaki disease can lead to complications just like complete Kawasaki disease can.